Hey there, yo-yos. I'm across the room doing something else right now while I'm doing this yo-yo review, which is why I sound like I'm across the room doing something else. Usually I don't think it's a good idea to do one thing and then do another thing at the same time, but I figure it's appropriate for this yo-yo that I'm going to be reviewing that I'm going to be over here working on building this table while I do the review. Okay.
That was a joke. I'm not very funny, but just so you know, I'm not going to build a table while I'm doing this yo-yo review. It's a kind of a yo-yo review slash unboxing slash warning, I guess is really what I would call it. And the yo-yo that I'm talking about is the chain reactor from Custom Yo-Yo, or Custom Yo. They seem to have several different names, Custom Yo, Custom Yo-Yo, Custom Products. They're a company that that does apparently make yo-yos, but their main business is making paintball guns. And Google Voice seems to agree. Anyhow, I've already played this yo-yo, so but I do want to do a little unboxing. I've put it back exactly the way it arrived. As you can see, they have pictures of the yo-yo on the box and. And it's just a great packaging. I think I love Yo-Yo, One Drop, Caribou Lodge. I think those three could really learn something from this company in terms of packaging. So let me go ahead and open up the box for you. I've put it back together the way it was when it arrived, which is like this. Yo-Yo comes on a card. There was a string that was just kind of sitting in there, and the string actually has, I don't know if you can see it, but it has a little red stain on it. I don't know if that was a sorting thing or what, but anyhow, the chain reactor from Custom Yo slash Custom Yo-Yo, Custom Products, has a diameter of 50 millimeters, a thickness of 26, and a weight of 48 grams. This is the first metal pocket yo-yo that I purchased. It also has a size bearing, which is really really awful. It comes shielded. I deshielded it. I like to deshield most of my bearings, so you can see the teeny tiny bearings. And the response is a friction pad, which normally I wouldn't cite a wiki, but the Yo-Yo Wiki, which is yoyowiki.org, seems to be really, really maintained. Something goes up, and then it seems that people will correct things almost immediately. So I recommend it. It seems like people argue a little bit on the wiki, which does cause problems. But anyway, the reason why I'm citing the Yo-Yo Wiki is because apparently, and this is according to the wiki, the original pad, which they call the brake pad, was copied from Playmax, and they had to turn over all of their parts to Playmax in some sort of a lawsuit settlement, and apparently the brake pad that you can see now that I'm looking at the screen, I can see that you couldn't see what was going on. The brake pad is is actually from a is bathtub non-slip slip sticker. I don't know. It's the Yo-Yo Wiki explains it. I would believe it, but actually, it really doesn't feel like that. I have a feeling they used something else. There is absolutely no groove. The pad is stuck on there. It's not recessed at all, and so it's. I wouldn't say it's very extremely responsive because of that, but it definitely. It's not recessed, and you definitely can't replace it with silicone. The reason why, let's see if we can get this back together. I haven't really shown you the Yo-Yo, which I have to apologize for. I don't really like doing bad reviews. If I see something that I'm playing and it's like this Yo-Yo, I just don't think it's something that I would recommend, then I'm going to tell you. I'm pretty, at this point, I'm pretty set in my ways of knowing what I like, and also knowing quality in terms of purchasing yo-yos. But being that this was the second, maybe third bearing yo-yo that I purchased, and I just didn't know what I was doing. One of the reasons why I purchased it, actually, is because I really like the graphics. I'm a designer, I like design, I like graphics, and I thought the shape was interesting, somewhat, yeah. So, got the Yo-Yo, very excited, first metal Yo-Yo, took it outside. Within the first 5 minutes, it split apart and rolled down the street, bouncing on the pavement, and we all know how happy that is. So that's what these scratches are from. It's from the Yo-Yo. And actually, it flew apart after that several times until I just went and bought some Teflon tape to keep it together. Let's see, what else? I think that's about it. I don't recommend this Yo-Yo. I think it's a secondary business for them at this point, there are too many wonderful yo-yo companies that are making really, really high quality yo-yos, because that's what their focus is, and I'm not gonna name any companies, but I recommend a little bit of research before purchasing your first metal yo-yo if you're new to this. I think that's pretty much it. I just wanted to show this to you, show you what my experience was with it. Again, the source in terms of that lawsuit that I am citing is the Yo-Yo Wiki. And, where's my high-tech Chiron? It's somewhere around here. So, more yo-yo reviews, video reviews, video maintenance, and unboxings can be found at sniffy-yo.blogspot.com. That's sniffy-yo.blogspot.com. And I'm always really interested in what people have to say. Interested in what people have to say. Any yo-yos that you guys think are interesting and should be checked out, I'm always willing to do that. I think the yo-yo community, the online yo-yo community, is very strong. It's very focused. It's very friendly, and I'm just really, really glad that I'm part of it. And so there you go, the chain reactor from custom yo-yo, custom, custom yo, custom products, and it's red. So, anyhow, I haven't tried their paintball stuff, but I have a feeling it's probably a little bit more more focused than their yo-yo side business. All right, thanks a lot.